Hello everyone. Introduction to Physical Sciences have three chapters. First chapter, we study the mathematics for physics. So this is some sections we have. Is the first section is the numbers and the unit. Today we are going to study the numbers and the unit, and the functions, vector and derivative and integrals. So today we are going to study the numbers and unit. The number of the unit, we have a subsection of the numbers, significant figures, and the unit. First of all, we'd like to study the numbers. So to describe the big numbers, often we use adding the many zeros. So one, the next one is a thousand, and the millions. Billions, trillions, quadrillions, quintillions, sextillions, septillions, octillions, nonillions, and decillions. It's quite difficult to count a number of zeros, so many zeros, especially for the decillions. So often we use a power index to describe big numbers and also describe the small numbers. To describe the power index, we have this is the expression in the power index. A times 10 to B, because the B is a power index. If we use a power index, all the big number can be expressed easily. 1,000 is 10 to 3, millions 10 to 6, billion 10 to 9. Trillion 10 to 12, quadrillion 10 to 15, and decillions 10 to 33. For example, if you want to describe the 30,000, is it going to be expressed 3 times 10 to 4? Also, we can express the small numbers. For example, 0.05 can be expressed 5 times 10 to minus 2. So power index is very useful to describe big number and also small numbers. Also sometimes we use the SI prefix to describe the big numbers and the small numbers. For example, deci means 10 to minus 1. Centi is 10 to minus 2. And milli is 10 to minus 3. Micro is 10 to minus 6. Nano is 10 to minus 9. Pico is 10 to minus 12. Femto is 10 to minus 15. Atto is 10 to minus 18. Zepto 10 to minus 21. And the octo is 10 to minus 24. For the big numbers, deca is 10. And hecto is 100. And the kilo is 1,000. And the mega is 10 to 6. And the giga is a 10 to 9. And tera, beta, exa, zeta, yota. So we'd like to show you the some example for the small case. So you might have learned deciliter. So this deci comes from the this d. Is actually 0.1 liter. So this can be converted to the 0.1s. Also centimeters. Centi is a 10 to minus 2, so it's 0.01 meter. So this is small numbers. In the case of the big ones, large numbers. Megabyte. This is 10 to 6 byte. So byte is actually this is a byte. Byte means actually 8 bit. And bit is a binary digit. It means 0 or 1. The byte is often used in the computers. Okay. Often use the SI prefix to describe the numbers in physical quantities. Then we'd like to move to the next topic of the significant figures. Significant figure is a number of the meaningful digit. When the width of a table is 1.3 to 4 meters, if you try to measure the width of the table with tape measures, then you might get these numbers. But this number means include actually errors. So 1.3241 meters, actually this is equal to 1.3235 meters to the 1.3244 meters. We are not sure about the real widths of our tables in these two ranges. So uncertainty of the widths of the table can be expressed 0.001 meters. So widths have four significant figures. 1, 2, 3, 4, four digits we have. So we said this is significant figures, has four significant figures. Then to find out the numbers, I need to explain the rules for rounding numbers. If the value of the number to the right of the rounding digit is less than 5, the rounding digit is left unchanged. If the value of the number to the right of the rounding digit is 5 or larger, the rounding digit is raised by 1. This is a rule for the rounding numbers. Then, when you want to perform the calculations, how can you calculate? In the case of the multiplications or divisions, so in this case, it is 1.5 times 1.23 over 0.9834. If you push the buttons in the calculators, you will get 1.87614. These kind of numbers you might get in your calculators. In the multiplications, always you have to count the significant figures of the each numbers. So in this case, significant figure is a 2, 1, 2. So in this case, 1, 2, 3, significant is a 3. So first 0.0 does not have any meaning. So 1, 2, 3, 4, four significant figures. Then you have to compare the significant figures and then pick up the lowest significant figures. So in this case, this is the lowest significant figure 2. Then you have to express the answers with the lowest significant figure of the 2s. So even if you have a 1.87614, you cannot express the answer in this way. Always you have to express the answers with a two significant figure in this case. The rounding digit is 8 in this case. Then you have to look at the numbers right of the rounding digit. In this case, 7. 7 is larger than the 5. So you have to increase the rounding digit. Is raised by 1, so it becomes 1.9. When you want to calculate addition or subtraction, always you have to think of the uncertainties. First one is uncertainty is 0.1. Second number is 0.01. Third one is 0.001. Then find the largest uncertainty. It comes from the first numbers. Then if you calculate the numbers, it becomes 2.284. But the answer should be expressed with the largest uncertainty. So in this case, you have to consider the 2 because this is the largest uncertainty. Then you have to look at the next numbers. Number to the right of the rounding digit is 8. Then you have to change the 2 to the 3s, raised by 1. So answer should be expressed 2.3 in this case. Okay, hope you understand significant figures. The next section is a unit. Physics, we use a SI unit. It's a system of units used around the world. In the mechanics, most of the case, we use MKS. M is a meters, K is a kilogram, and S is second. So distance, for example, in the case of the distance, to describe the unit, we use this symbol. And distance of X, the unit is L. So this L comes from this one. So unit is meters. The speed is V. Is unit is L divided by T. This T, L and T. So this is meter per second. Okay, so this is the end of this section.